First and 10, Comets.
All right, welcome back here. Second quarter here. We had some difficulties with our audio once again, but we are back. We had the switch cameras here. And we're back here, and the Comets have ball on the 22-yard line. Looks as if there's a fumble.
Fumble on the play, recovered by number 50, Alex McBee. It'll be Cavalier ball.
It looks like the Cavaliers jumped on that ball. As soon as they saw it, came loose.
Ball will be spotted on the Caston 25-yard line.
Hand off to number 40, Jake.
Number 40, Josh Kursik on the run. Over the right side. Tackled by number 40, Olt. And 20, Hartman. Ball spotted on the Caston 24-yard line. Will be second down and 9.
Handoff play. He's up to 27 spin. I think it's all up to
the
15-yard line.
Tackled on the carry over the left side. Picks up a Cavalier first down. Tackled by 53, Trent Howard. Looks like the ball spotted close to the 6-yard line. Where it'll be first and goal, Cavaliers.
Be here first and goal here for the Cavaliers. First and goal. Flag is thrown onto the field.
Coachman on the Comets. That'll move it half the distance to the goal line. We'll spot the ball on the 3-yard line where it'll be first and goal from the 3 Cavaliers.
Handoff. And he stopped.
Touchdown. First touchdown
of the game by the Cavaliers. Let's look at that replay of the drive. Comets fumble. Cavaliers recover the ball.
On the kick for the Cavaliers.
Cavaliers drive down to Ben Handoff.
Enrique
all the way up to the 10-yard line. Flag was thrown onto the field by the Comets. And that's going to put the Cavaliers up to about the 3-yard line, and they run it in for the touchdown. And the field goal is good.
The kick is up and good. At the 10-minute, 25-second mark of the second quarter, it's your Cavaliers 8, Caston 0. Check that.
I think it's 7, not 8.
On junior high rules. We're going to move to high school rules. 7-0.
Okay, so 7-0. I was really confused there for a second. I was like, it surely can't be 8.
Make sure you sign up for the Culver Wings halftime kick for pizza. There will also be a auto park challenge at halftime. So make sure all fans listen for the auto park challenge at halftime. Back to kick for the Cavaliers, number 20, Enrique Faninas. Back deep for the Comets are number 8, Albright. And number 40, Casey Alt.
Number 40, Casey Alt. And Number 8, Blake Albright will be back to receive the ball out here as the Cavaliers kick it off. And flag is thrown, and that's going to be on the Cavaliers. And they're going to move the ball back 5 yards. So instead of the ball will be on the 45, the ball will actually be on the 35 now, as Cavaliers will kick the ball off to the Comets. He's up to the 30. That's the, actually, 29.
Albright on the return for about 10 yards, hit by a couple Cavaliers. Carter Stevens on the tackle.
Finish second, or if there's a timeout, I'm not sure.
Be here first down for the Comets. Let's see what they can do on this position of offense. And it looks like he is stopped right immediately as he hikes the ball. I guess Brady Hartman, I don't know if that was a sneak. Was that a quarterback sneak call? Kind of interesting to start the offensive position on start. Brady Hartman looking, scrambling, and that's going to be an incomplete pass.
Hartman's pass is incomplete.
And that's going to bring up third down here with 9 yards to go for the Comets.
Bring up third down and 9, Comets.
Oh, Pete.
Nothing. I didn't realize you were on the air still.
Hand off play to take Cal number 7. Maybe picked up one on the run.
Run over the left
run.
Side, tackled by number 50, Alexander McBee.
That's going to bring up fourth down here for the Comets.
Couple yards. Ball spotted at the 31-yard line of the Comets, where it'll be fourth and 8.
And tonight is homecoming
back
for the Cavaliers.
For the Cavaliers, number 1, Troy Bolds, set to kick for the Comets, number 86, James Keel.
Hello.
James Keel is back to punt the ball off to the Cavaliers. If only the Comets would look up and see the ball, they're going to place the ball right at the 45.
Snuggles up right at the Cavalier 45-yard line. It will be first and 10, Cavaliers.
End off play. Gets, maybe picks
Troy
up
Bolds
1 yard on the
number 40.
On the handoff. Casey Alt with the stop. Casey Alt's been very strong on the defensive end so far.
Ball spotted at the Cavaliers.
He's been very healthy for the Comets. Same with number 53, Trent Howard, known as the Ginger Milkshake. Those two have been really good on the defensive end, and also you're getting to see number 82, the freshman, Hunter Shadlob, getting a lot of playing time here. The last couple of games, been great to see him play. It looks like he gets up to the 40.
Number one, Troy Bowles on the carry.
And as he runs out of bounds.
Seven, Tate Towell.
Does he not like getting hit?
And number eight, Blake Albright. They'll move the chains. That'll bring up a Cavalier. First down. Spot the ball at the Comets 35-yard line.
Hand off play. He's up to the, gets up to the 20.
Matt Sutter on the carry.
Gets up to the 30-yard line.
Tackled by number eight, Blake Albright.
Blake Albright on the stop there for the Comets.
That'll bring up a second down play for the Cavaliers. They'll spot the ball at the 28-yard line. Second down and four.
Hand off play once again by the Cavaliers. It is up to the 20, up to the about 15, almost up to the 10. Gets up to the 17-yard line for the Cavaliers. Cavaliers keep running the ball up on the Comets defense.
This one will spot the ball at the Caston 13-yard line. First and 10, Cavaliers from the Caston 13.
End off play. And he's going up to the 10, reaches out, fumble. He tried to reach out to get the
blow it dead.
Tried to get the TD, but
he's at the 2-yard line, so it'll be first.
He gets stopped.
Cavaliers
at the 2-yard line.
2-yard line.
So it's gonna be our first.
Blake Albright on the tackle.
Nice job, Blake.
Flag on the play, procedure, Cavaliers.
That's going to back the Cavaliers up 5 yards.
Cavalier ball from the Caston 7.
Let's see if the Comets can stop him here on first down 7. Handoff play. Comets can't.
Matt Sutter on the carry.
Comets can't really stop that run number play, so the Cavaliers are going to continue to run the ball. Haven't really seen that much of a passing game
four.
From the Cavaliers yet. Take it down here with 4 yards to go.
I understand your goals.
And I'll play it once again. He's touchdown.
The line of scrimmage. Reporting Casey Ault on the tackle.
Looks like Casey Ault stalked
them. The yard, they'll spot the ball at the Caston.
I couldn't really
line.
See what was going on there.
Third down play.
Looks as if they scored a touchdown, but I guess Casey Ault stopped them. The rain has stopped here at Culver. Well, actually, it's kind of sprinkling, but it's a very chilly night here at Culver Stadium.
Timeout.
Timeout is called by the Cavaliers. Once again, thank you for tuning in to RTC TV 4.
followed by the auto park punt.
All right, and welcome back to RTC TV 4.
Oil change.
Once again, thanks for tuning in, and be sure to check out our website, www.rtctv4.com. You can find all the videos of high school sports. We're covering Argus, Caston, Tippy Valley, and Rochester. So be sure to go check that out, and you'll find all your favorite high school sports on there being covered by RTC TV 4.
Southern on the carry. Tackled by number 40, Casey Alt. And number 8, Blake Albright. They'll spot the ball at the 1 yard line. Fourth and goal from the 1. Timeout, Caston.
All right, well, timeout called by the comments. We'll be right back after this short break. And welcome back to RTC TV 4. Fourth and goal. Ball is placed on the 1 yard line. Let's see what the Cavaliers would do here. I think if I was in this situation, I would probably go for it. But then again, we have no idea what the Cavaliers would do here. It looks like they're going for it. And then quarterback sneak. And I think he stopped. I think that's going to be turnover on down. And the Comets coaching staff is saying no good, and it looks like it's no good.
Did not get it. Comets will take over on downs from the 1 yard line.
That was an amazing defensive play by there by the Comets.
That worked out last time.
Yeah, that's all we have to do.
All right, so the Comets will start out with the ball on offense at the 10-yard line. Let's see if they can get some work done here. Looks like
flag on the play.
Flag is thrown out into the field.
Procedure against the Comets.
That's going to back the Comets up.
Not sure where they're going to mark this one, half the distance. We'll say 1 yard line. Make sure you visit our award-winning concession stand before the halftime festivities.
Safety.
Safety on the play.
And that's going to put the Cavaliers
9-0. Safety was number 74, Chris Zahner. All on the run. At the 4 minute mark of the second quarter, it's your Cavaliers 9, Caston 0. The Comets will free kick from the 20 yard line.
Well, now the Comets will have to kick the ball off to the Cavaliers.
Back deep for the Cavaliers, number one, Troy Bowles.
So, Cavaliers will have another. Now they'll have the ball on offense. And let's see if the Comets can turn around and make a defensive stop like they did the last time.
Brady Hartman, number 20, will kick to the
But they have only been impressed with the Comets. This game is their defense. They haven't really gotten able to do anything on the offense end. But they'll get something figured out here within the next quarter.
No,
4 minutes remaining here in the second quarter. Misses him. He's up to the 40. And he stops right at the 40.
With a flag on the play.
Flag is thrown onto the field once again. We'll see if that's going to come back or go forward.
Looks like it will be a sideline penalty on the Caston Comets.
That's the Comets' second sideline penalty of the game.
First, the other one was on the Caps.
The officials will spot the ball at the Caston 23-yard line. Will be first and 10, Cavaliers.
Timeout.
And timeout is called out to the field. We'll be right back after this short break. Timeout. Thanks for tuning to the RTC TV4. And welcome back, everyone, to RTC TV4. Comets have the ball. I mean, the Cavaliers have the ball on the 23-yard line. Hand off. He's up to 20.
Number one, Troy Bowles on the run. Tackled by Casey Alt.
But here's taken down here for the Cavaliers with 7 yards to go. Hand off play. And he's stopped by
Matt Sutter on the run.
Number 72, Dylan Tabler on the stop.
Tackled by number 72, Dylan Tabler, and number 40, Casey Alt.
Third down here for the Cavaliers. Looking for the pass into the end zone. And that's going to be a touchdown.
Number 20. Enrique Ferdinand in for the extra point. Time out.
Thanks for tuning in to RTC TV 4. We'll be right back after this short break. Welcome back, everybody, to the RTC TV 4. The Cavaliers about to kick their... Cavaliers going for two here instead of one. I mean, who wouldn't want to go for two? I mean, two is greater than one. So let's see if they can get this. Two-point conversion.
It's called ghost timeout.
Pass play. Finds him, and it is complete. For the two-point conversion.
For the two-point conversion. At the 2-minute 58 mark of the second quarter, it's your Cavaliers 17, Caston 0.
I'm okay.
Sure?
So far.
Yeah. It's cold, I am.
It is cold. I'm just kind of like.
Are we going to switch at halftime?
As I was talking to Maddox, it is really chilly out here. He was wondering if I was holding up okay with this cold weather. And so far, you know, I'm honestly holding up pretty fine. You know, I'm just trying to stay calm here.
And number 8, Albright, set to kick.
Only if you guys at home could experience this. Blake Albright receives the ball, and he's up to the 20, up to the 25, gets up to the 30, up to the 40, up to the 45. He stopped. That was a great
Albright with the run back.
That was a great receive by Blake Albright. Puts him up all the way up to the 45.
Run back. They'll spot the ball at the Caston 45-yard line. It'll be first and 10, Comets.
Go defense! Pass
play. Brady's looking, finds Tate Cal for the complete pass.
Hartman's pass is complete.
Okay, incomplete pass. I thought he might have had it.
Incomplete.
But incomplete.
Second and 10, Cummins.
Oh, dude. Fumble.
Hartman on the run. He's hit by Alexander McBee.
That was a hard hit. I'd love to see that replay 40, in slow-mo.
Josh Kursik.
Wow.
It's going to be Cavalier ball. First and 10.
Now let's see if the Cavaliers can score before the half here.
Officials will spot the ball at the Caston 32-yard line.
That was one hard hit. I wouldn't be surprised if Brady Hartman would be a little shooken up after that. Might be seeing a couple of stars. But that's okay. He'll be all right.
Just a little bit, Pete. Welcome back.
Yeah,
I understand. Give you something cool.
End off. Gets up to the 19-yard line.
The run. He's tackled by number 20, Brady Hartman.
Up to the.
And Casey Ault picked up close to 4 yards, where it'll be second down and six.
Second down and six to go here for the Cavaliers with 2 minutes and 10 seconds remaining here in the second quarter.
Pete, what are you doing? Pete's unscrewing the ball. So, very content.
Pass play here. Looking. Finds number 84 for a complete pass.
Eagles pass is complete to number 84, Nate Carnegie Jr. Number 12, Zach Conrad on the tackle. He'll spot the ball at the 8-yard line. It'll be first and goal, Cavaliers.
Ball is on the 8-yard line here for the Cavaliers. 1 minute and 40 seconds remain here in the second quarter. Handoff play, and he's going up for the touchdown.
Number one ball for the referee, touchdown.
For the Cavaliers.
Number 20, Enrique Farias on for the extra point. It's up and good.
And it is
at
good.
The 1:35 mark of the second quarter.
And the Comets
24-0. And Susan Kanchak, please meet Mr. Barrett in the north end zone for the Culver Wings halftime kick for pizza. Back to kick for the Cavaliers, Enrique Farinas, deep for the Comets, number 40.
Number 40, Casey Ault, number 8,
Blake Albright.
Blake Albright will be back to receive the ball. Kick is up and away. And that's going to be a touchback, and that's the ball is going to be placed at the 20-yard line touchback for the Comets.
The Comet will take over. Spot the ball at their own 20-yard line. Will be first and 10, Comets.
Oh,
Tay gets up to the 43-yard line.
Number 40, KCL on the run.
KCL hasn't, I haven't really seen him in the running back position that much this game. It's been mostly Tate Cowell, which is kind of odd. I've never seen Tate Cowell at the running back position.
Ball spotted on their own 23-yard line.
One minute remain here in the second quarter. Oh, up to the four, 40, about 38-yard line.
Number 40, Josh Persick picks up a first down.
That's going to bring up a first down here for the Comets.
They'll mark the ball at the Caston 37-yard line. First and 10, Comets from their own 37. Timeout.
Comments. Once again, thanks for tuning in to RTC TV 4. We'll be right back after this short break. And welcome back, everyone. It's first down and 10 for the Comets. Ball is placed on the 37-yard line. Pass play here. Brittany Hartman looking, tosses the ball up. Intercepted. Casey, y'all. I don't understand why Brittany Hartman just tosses the ball up like that. It's like if there's no one there, they just didn't throw it out of bounds or something.
Caston, 25-yard line, first and 10 Cavaliers with 35.8 seconds left in the half.
Pass play here. Finds. Out of bounds. Incomplete.
To Ethan Schumann is incomplete. Out of bounds. 29.7 seconds. It'll be second down and 10. Cavaliers.
29 seconds to go here in the second quarter before the halftime.
Ball still on the Caston 25-yard line.
Pass play. Looking. Takes off running.
Beaver
and runs out of bounds.
Forced out of bounds by number 8, Blake Albright. 21.7 seconds left in the half. The ball will be spotted at the Caston 10-yard line. The first and goal Cavaliers.
Thank you. handoff. Gets up there, pushes in, and that's going to be a touchdown. That's three touchdowns in the last 2 minutes of the second quarter for the Cavaliers.
Number 20, Enrique Farinas in for the extra point. The kick is good at the 16.5 second mark of the second quarter. It's your Cavaliers, 31,
Cavaliers
Caston
lead 31-0.
On the kick for the Cavaliers, number 20, Enrique Farinas. Back deep, Blake Albright, number 8, and number 40, Casey Oak.
Casey Alt pushes through, stopped at the
tackled by number 44,
33-yard line.
And 33, Jake Fisher. And 32, Matt Southern. And the ball's on the 32. It'll be first and 10, Comets.
Nine seconds to go here in the second quarter before the half.
Take Cal on the run.
And that's going to end it. Into the half. So grab yourself some popcorn, grab yourself some snacks, and come back and watch the second half. Once again, thanks for tuning to the RTCG TV4.
Casey Hall.
Hey everybody, and welcome back to RTC TV. My name is Dakota Hayden, and I'll be taking over for Galen Rensler here in the second half.
Flag
so
on the play.
The Comets is still down 31-0.
And it's still on
the ball. And it's spot the ball at the 35-yard line. It'll be first and 10.
The Cavaliers
to start the second half.
It's like a nice brisk 60 degrees, and it's pretty cold up here, and I'm freezing. Just to give you kind of the idea of the standpoint that I am right now, I'm having a wonderful time, but I might be using a little bit of sarcasm, but you'll have to judge that for yourselves. Alright, so we're setting up for the Comets to take the offensive here. So far, been a bit of a rough game for the Comets so far. It was raining, just downpouring in the first half, so it's gonna take a little bit to get us back in the game.
Number 40, Alt on the run. No gain, tackled by number 58, Marcellus Anderson. And number 74, Chris Sater.
So we're not moving anywhere with that. It is just chilly. That's an understatement. It's cold. Stop! I mean, it could always be worse. It could be raining right now. But as I say, that's not right. Comets setting up for another offensive play. Handoff. Number 40, Casey Alt. He gains some yards. Nice run.
Holt on the run.
Really nice
run. Rambles forward. Close to the 44-yard line, tackled by a host of Cavaliers.
Go, Cavaliers, go!
Number 80, Ethan Schumann, bottom of that pile. He'll slap the ball at the 44-yard line. Third and short, Comets.
Just 1 yard short there for the first down. Third and one. Three and one. Easiest. Good handoff play.
Colt on the run.
58 for Culver, getting a little bit rougher.
Chris Sainer on the tackle. Your first That's down for nice. The Comets. They'll move the chains. They'll spot the ball at the 46-yard line.
Apologize if I keep doing that, folks. It's like I said, it's cold out here. I'm dying,
to be quite frank.
All right. First and 10 from the Comets. Right here, handoff play. Going to play number 40, Caston. Nice spin maneuvers out there. Gain in the
air. Oh, hammers forward. Close to a 7-8 yard gain there.
Number
40, Josh Persick on the tackle.
Again, if you're just tuning in.
Ball on the Cavalier 46-yard line. Second down and three.
We had a little bit of trouble with the audio, so I'll be taking over for the second half here. So you get to, you didn't get to miss out on my lovely voice. I'm still here. I get a say in this game. So lucky you.
Lucky me.
Lucky us. Let's work together.
Right, handoff play. And didn't gain too much yards there.
That's for sure.
Ball on the carry. King Lamar on the tackle. Russell Temme also.
Out for a first down there for all. Nice. We're looking like
start the ball
at
the Cavalier 43-yard line. Will be first and 10 Comets.
Micah. Shut up, Micah.
Comets setting up again. About 9 minutes left to go in the third quarter.
Tate Cowell on the carry. Loss of one on the play.
Loss of a yard by Tate there.
Spot the ball at the 44 and a half yard line.
Now, once again, it's pretty cold up here.
58 Marcellus Anderson on the tackle.
Commentary, but it at least gives me the perfect view to see how many people came out to support the Comets. One, I'd like to point out in particular, Micah Paul, which I can hear him from all the way over here. It's nice to see him come to the games and giving all the support there. I'd like to thank Micah Paul for that. He's a great guy. But hopefully that'll be enough enthusiasm and cheering to get them somewhere, but not
there.
Hit by
number 58, Marcellus Anderson.
And welcome back. Once again, thank you for tuning in to RTC TV. Comets still trailing by 31 points. It is not looking to be a good game so far tonight, but hopefully we're getting enough momentum to push back. Comets taking up the offensive here, 3 and 13 to go. And it looks like to be a pass play. Brady looking. Ooh, pass is complete to, who is that?
Hartman's pass to
who is
eight,
that?
Blake Albright.
It was Blake Albright with the completion on that pass. Nice.
Shower on the tackle.
Nice.
Bring
nice.
Up a fourth and six play from the Cavalier.
That's going to put it 4 and 6.
9-yard line.
Now, we all know this, but I'm a risk taker here. I'd go for it, but I don't know what our game plan is here. But we're down by 31 points, so honestly, we're not losing anything. So I'd go for it. That's just me. Comets setting up here. Looked to be going for a pass, but
Hartman, tackled by number 40,
couldn't find
Josh
anyone
Persick
to pass it to. Well, then again, I'd rather take that than
that
apparently what happened second quarter where
Cavaliers.
He threw the ball and there was no one there to receive it.
Cavaliers ball first and 10 from the there.
But he's trying.
45
I'll give him
yard
that.
Line.
And that's going to be a turnover on downs and send it back Culver's way. All right, Culver setting up to take the offensive. Don't know what they're going to do. It looks like they're going to go for, oh, he's running it. Brought down by number 40, KC Alt.
Tackled by number 40, KC Alt. Close to the line of scrimmage where it'll be second and 10, Cavaliers.
The Cavaliers sitting at roughly the 45-yard line. For second and 10, nice stop by Casey. He's been doing really well this game. All right, setting up for another play. Handoff is brought down. Didn't get too far. Comets defense really kicking it into gear here. Hopefully we can keep him back.
And number 20, Brady Hartman. Ball be spotted at the Cavalier 47-yard line, third down and 8.
Once again, we got a few players missing out there for the Comets. We got number 3, Phoenix Singleton, who's out with a mild concussion. We got Efren, who's still suffering a bit from a shoulder injury, and we got number 35, Colton Welker. That's, I do believe there's something wrong with his leg, a torn ACL maybe. But so far, they're great assets to the team, but so far, we might be able to pull something without him. And that was a little bit, oh, he's not down. Bring him down.
Number 1, Troy Gold on the carry.
And he's,
Skipper's down to the Caston 5-yard line.
That was a nice run by Culver. Oh, that annoys me.
The first and goal Cavaliers from the Caston 5-yard line.
That's not, that's, wow. All right, Culver, first down to 5 to go. I'm not so sure what they tried there. I think they went for a run. And they made a touchdown. That's not, why? Why can't we make touchdowns? Now I'll put Culver up 37-0. They're gonna, looks like they're gonna go for the field goal.
Number 20, Enrique Farinas on for the extra point.
I'm hoping some kind of natural event occurs for him to miss. But of course, that's not going to happen.
Kick
and they
up,
get the extra point. That is a good
at
kick.
5 minute, 21 second mark of the third quarter. It's your Cavaliers.
That's
going
to sit at 38 to nothing.
Zero.
And since I'm in the mood for shouting people out, I'd like to give a shout out to the managers for the Caston football team, Alyssa and Lexi. They do a great job keeping the team in order. It looks like Culver getting party rock down in here.
Number 7, take
and they're about ready to kick it back off to the Comets. Receiving, as always, will be number 8, Blake Albright. And well, it looks like we got 7 Tate down in there. Kick by Culver. A nice kick. Very nice kick. I'll give him that. Oh. Culver just being a bunch of big meanies pushing down their own players.
Comets will take the ball at the 35-yard line. It'll be first and 10. Comets.
All right, Comets retaking the offensive here. Come on, we got 5 minutes and 21 seconds to do something good in the third quarter. We can do it. Something, anything, please.
Also, John Curtis Browder, LLC, gatekeeping. In golf cart business.
Comets setting up, ready to go. And handoff right to Casey. A gainage of a yard.
On the carry.
Maybe 2.
Tackled by Alex Russell Temme. Falls forward for a gain of a couple yards.
Ooh, that's going to be 3 yards.
Second down.
Yards are yards. Whatever gets us closer to the goal.
8-yard line.
Clock's a ticking and we keep moving. Let's go. It's setting up, handoff play again. Casey with a nice spin maneuver there.
Cavaliers. Demi, Persick, Lamar, King, McBee on the tackle.
Well, the Comets trying to figure out a strategy here. So far what they've been doing has been working, but they need something to gain more yards.
At the 40-yard line.
I mean, obviously, who wouldn't want to gain more yards? But strategies are strategies. They're setting up for a handoff. I don't think there was a gain there.
Tate Cowell on the carry.
There's a handoff to Tate. Try to switch things up.
We'll bring up fourth and five. Number 86, James Keel. Back to punt. Number one.
Who we got? Number 86, James Keel to punt. I do believe this is the first game I've seen him punt for. When normally it'd be number three Phoenix, but he's out with the mild concussion, so it makes sense. Nice kick. Nice kick.
Ball rolls down inside the 20-yard line.
That's going to sit about 18, maybe, yard line.
17-yard line will be first and 10.
17, might be one off. First and 10, handed it back off to the Cavaliers with about 3 minutes and 14 seconds left to go for the third quarter.
Just want to go home.
Been a very interesting game so far tonight, but you know, it'd be more interesting if we could score a point. But we're trying, we're trying. Comet set up to take the defense here. Flag on the play. I didn't really see what that would have been called on. Let's see what the ref says it's going to be.
Motion on the Cavaliers. It'll back them up.
It's going to be a motion on the Cavaliers. That's nice. That'll push them back and help us out, definitely.
Ball's on the 12-yard line, where it'll be first and long, first and 15, Cavaliers.
Well, put the Cavaliers first to 15, as you can see. And 3 minutes left on the clock. Comets setting up to keep the defense going. And he's running out there, get him down.
Troy Bulls on the carry.
That was a decent run by 20, Brady Cavaliers. That'll gain him some yards, that's for sure.
The second down play, second and about four from the 23-yard line.
Second and four for the Cavaliers. Oh, I apologize, folks. I'm stuttering here a bit. It's really cold up here. Looked to be a handoff play. He was looking for a place to go through, but he was stopped by number 40, Alt.
Third down and short. Ball on the Cavalier 25-yard line.
Casey's doing a pretty good job tonight. Multiple tackles, decent runs. If we can get him through and make a touchdown, that'd be great. Handoff play. And he had an opening, but it's brought down.
Picks up enough yardage for the first down.
But that still gave him first down. Man, with a minute and 25 left to go, we're just not getting anywhere this third quarter.
34-yard line.
Okay. Caston setting up for the defense here. They've been working so far pretty well, but the Culver's been able to break through a couple times, just like almost that.
Holds on the carry.
There's a nice stop by the Comets. If he would have gone through, he would have been gone.
Hunter Shainlob on the tackle.
Oh, Hunter Shainlob had the tackle. Number 86, I do believe.
Left in the third quarter.
Nice tackle. And here we are, we're in the end of the third quarter. Moving on to the fourth quarter, where you will still get to hear my lovely voice for the rest of this game. And it'll be a wonderful time. Handoff. And he's got an opening. He's taking it. Bring him down. Come on. Number 53, Trent Howard, able to bring him down. Oh, man. I'm not liking this at all, folks.
53, Trent Howard on the tackle. They'll move the chains.
Oh, boy. Oh, man. This is bad. And that's going to put an end to the third quarter. Thanks again for tuning in to RTC TV, and I will see all you guys in the next quarter. Thank you. All right, welcome back to RTC TV. In case you forgot, my name is Dakota Hayden. I'll be your solo commentator for the second half of tonight's game in replace of Galen Rensselaer, who did an excellent job in the first half.
40, Josh Kursick on the run.
And it looks
tackled
like
by number 40, Casey Ault.
Culver might have got a few yards in there in that play.
And 58, John Mitchell. No gain on the play.
Oh, maybe not. There
second
wasn't a gain.
10, Cavaliers.
It's very, very cold up here in the press box as we enter the final quarter of the game. Hopefully I can get out of here and warm myself up a little bit. But hey, I'm happy to sit out here and provide excellent commentary for all you folks back home. All right, helmet setting up for the defense. Yeah, it looks like a handoff play, and he's way out there in the open. He fumbled it. Recovered.
Fumble on the play.
It's getting exciting.
Caston number 40, Casey Ault.
There's number 40, Casey Ault on that recovery. Nice.
They
want to gain some yards here, some momentum.
Comets will take over on downs. Comets.
That'll put first and 10 for the Comets. All right. Hopefully we can finally get on the scoreboard after three consecutive games of not scoring a single touchdown. I hate to say it, but it's true. All right, welcome back. Comets setting up to take an offensive play. It looks like there's a handoff to number 7, Ted Cowell. He gained yards.
Cowell on the run. over the left side, tackled by number 84, Nate Carnegie Jr. He'll mark the ball.
Surprised he didn't
44 yard line, second down and one. Comments.
I'll take what I can do.
And they don't give out, like, Division III schools, they don't give out.
So what they're going to do next. It's 2-1. He's got one measly yard to go, three stinking feet to get somewhere.
No, like, it doesn't have that.
Yeah.
It's more medical.
Isaiah Conrad on the run.
Most of them private and the is like 42,000.
Over the first down marker for a Comet first down. They'll slot the ball at the Comet.
It's a big private school.
48 yard line. Where it'll be first and 10. Caston.
But tuition is crazy, dude. Highest in the state.
$46,000. It's ridiculous.
Well, that's just like absolutely. You can always do that.
Like Ball State. Albright
on the run. Tackled by number 76, Noah King. And number 70, Carter Stevens.
The can.
Second down and 11. Ball mark at the Caston 47 yard line. Don't forget the homecoming dance coming up after the game. Homecoming dance on the track after the game. BJART in the house.
Right here, ball!
What?
Fumble on the play.
Oh,
very good. Caston recovers, number 77.
Chris
Smith on the recovery.
My Chris Smith at 77. I was about ready to flip my rig. Get that ball, go, go,
go, get that ball, go, go, get that ball, go. We will.
We'll bring up the third down play for the Comets. Turn about 11. Ball still marked at the Comet 47 yard line.
Score on the board.
Oh, the run.
Please.
Must be a crime.
Pass. Oh, incomplete.
Hartman's pass to Powell's incomplete.
He's been throwing a lot of passes this game.
Bring up fourth down.
That one? No.
Remember, students, you will have to leave the stadium.
Flashback. Second quarter.
To come back in for the homecoming dance.
I'm trying to make him feel better about himself. Okay, I remember second quarter.
Homecoming dance after the game. DJ ART in the house.
I love it when I'm right.
Hartman's pass incomplete. Number 8. Albright. That will turn the ball over on downs to the Cavaliers. First and 10 Cavaliers from the Caston 47 yard line.
We have not been doing long passes. But we've been passing. It's a plus, that means we're expanding our repertoire. Strategic, plays, but they're definitely not working. I take back what I said. 3:30 fucking hot. Little less than that. He's got an opening. He's way out of. Oh boy.
Ziad's handoff to Caleb Jones. He rambles across the first down marker for a Cavalier first down.
Number 60,
Mark Smith on the tackle for the Comets.
We're taking him down. If he would have ran it back,
officials will spot the ball at the
across the stadium. I can't even throw
it in. 34 yard line.
That's not good.
Paul T.
No!
I gotta go pee! I'm
gonna take a short break here while the meds check, the insurance checks on.
I didn't touch you.
Yeah, I was gonna tell you.
Yeah, I know. I was worried.
You still could get through that.
Hey, they're not gonna hear that as much as this because I'm not there. I'm right here.
Okay.
Huh?
I think definitely hear that.
Well, that's your fault.
Yeah.
You're a bad cameraman. Hey, if Tate's out, we're done. We do realize. Oh, he's out.
Oh, he's out.
I meant, like, if he's out, like, the rest of the season, we're done.
Oh, yeah.
Remember, Culver, middle, high school students, there is a $2 there, like, cover charge for the homecoming dance. You must leave the stadium and come back in for a $2 charge. Proceeds will go to student council. To do a lot of good things for you. I guarantee it. State law.
And we're back. Thanks for that tape. We were able to walk himself off the field. Hopefully it wasn't anything too serious. We're going to go back to the game. So next week.
Probably
he might be sitting out the rest of this one, I would think. Handoff by the Cavaliers.
Yeah, just handoff. Caleb Jones on the right side. Picks up a few yards. Tackled by Caston's 44. Zach Slocum.
We don't have two in the morning. We just keep going.
Tackled by Zach.
Cavaliers! Cavaliers! That ball is short!
Number 20, Bunnyness on the run. Over the left side. Picks up a couple yards. Bring up a third down play, third down and five. Ball is spotted at the 27 yard line. The Comets.
So far, not too much avail, but it's working. And ball.
26 Jones on the carry over the right side, flag on the play. 77 Smith on the tackle.
What was that flag for? What was it for?
Block in the back. Block.
Alright.
Penalty on the Cavaliers, that'll back them up.
Okay, that's helpful. That's helpful. We can work with that.
Blocking on the back side.
Hopefully. Maybe a score. I'm asking for a lot for about a minute left in the fourth quarter. But I believe.
Spot the ball on the 33 yard line. Will be third down and about nine.
Caston setting up to take the defensive here. Three times for Culver to go. Three and around here. Still a minute left to go on the clock. And, as we go on with this minute, I'd like to take this time and do a little self-advertising if you want that. Feel free to check out the RTC TV4 website.
Siaja on the road, tackled by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 comments.
Like one, previous ones, where you get to hear my lovely voice.
Lost on the play, we're doing 4
for all of eternity because it's on the internet and it never goes away. Feel free to also check out our YouTube channel. And, yeah,
remember, students, you must exit the stadium. And then come back in for our homecoming festivities, our homecoming dance.
Like, it really is cool to know that people actually watch the content all throughout this. So I'd like to just say thank you all, the viewers watching right now, making it this far, for tuning in. And it looks like that's going to end it here tonight. Time to lose 38 to 0, which unfortunately makes
it. Final whistle. The end of the game score is your Cavaliers 38, Caston 0 for a homecoming.